63, The Beach Boys, and Surfer Girl. Kind of a twin spin there. Also, right before that, we heard Barbara Ann from The Beach Boys jumping up a couple of years to 66. These are The Silhouettes, and you can go get a job. From 1982, Dionne Warwick, and For You. You can hear the business news and numbers you need every weekday morning at 7:35 during the business block with reports from Gordon Williams and Tom Butenhoff. And tune in for Tom Butenhoff afternoons for the closing stock numbers at about 5:40 right here on Sauk County's information station, WRDB. Simply read, stars. Anyone who ever... Great new release from Simply Red, that's Stars, right here on Sauk County's Best Music, AM 1400, WRDB. Checking sports, Magic Johnson says his NBA career might not be over forever. The Los Angeles Lakers star says he'll meet with his doctors this week and may have an announcement about his future plans later on in the week. Johnson became the fifth Laker to have his uniform number retired, but he hinted that his retirement may not be permanent. Telling fans he hopes they won't be upset if we do this all over again, Johnson left the door open to returning to the NBA, at least part-time. Johnson says if he decides to come back, we have to come up with a good game plan. Maybe you don't have to play back-to-back. Johnson announced his retirement from the NBA last November 7th after learning he has the virus that causes AIDS. He already has played in the NBA All-Star Game and plans on playing in the Summer Olympics. That wreck at Daytona knocked out many of the favorites about halfway through the race, and that opened the way for Allison to win his first Daytona 500 title. His father Bobby won the race three times. Davey Allison led 127 of the last 145 laps, losing the lead only on pit stops during caution flags. Morgan Shepherd finished second, Jeff Bowden third, Alan Kulwicki fourth, and Dick Trickle fifth. And checking scores from earlier today in the NBA, finals to report, Detroit 90, Philadelphia 83, Orlando got past our Milwaukee Bucks 118-104, it was Charlotte 126, Miami 109, Boston once again over the Lakers today 114-107. In the fourth quarter at this hour, San Antonio leads Sacramento 97-91, and at the half it's Portland 53, and the LA Clippers 43. Over in college basketball, number one Duke keeps rolling. They take care of a victory 71-63 today over North Carolina State. And in the NHL finals, New Jersey 4, the New York Rangers 2. It was Buffalo 5 and Hartford 4. And a tie in overtime had Pittsburgh and Philadelphia at 3 apiece. One other final, Toronto 7 and Edmonton 5. In the third period, it's Chicago 5 and Calgary 4. In 30 seconds, I'll check our forecast, which involves a lot of precipitation over the next couple of days.
When you turn on your furnace,
we have 33 degrees and some light drizzle in the area. Here's a check of our forecast for the rest of tonight. Mostly cloudy skies, areas of fog developing a little bit later on, and a low reaching 31. On Monday, cloudy skies, a chance of light rain by late morning, and a high of 43. On Monday night, light rain mixing with snow, then changing over to wet snow, with accumulations likely and a low of 35. And Tuesday, well, you guessed it, wet snow continuing, additional accumulations likely, and high reaching 38. 33 degrees currently, with light drizzle in Reedsburg.
Another great weekend with Sauk County.
Simon and Garfunkel, Mrs. Robinson. A look at the community calendars upcoming. This is Waterfront and Nature of Love from Sauk County's Best Music. Minutes before 11 o'clock at WRDB, and in community items, the Sauk County Dairy Breakfast Committee will hold its organizational meeting for the 1992 Dairy Breakfast, and that'll be happening tomorrow at Mike's Kitchen Restaurant at 8 p.m. And the restaurant is located on Highway 12 near Sauk City.
Push trouble free.
From 1980, Andy Gibb and a little help from Olivia Newton-John. And I can't help it. Well, I can't help telling you about our wet weather forecast, but here it is anyway. 33 degrees, we have some areas of drizzle in the area, and for the rest of tonight, mostly cloudy skies. We will see some areas of fog a little bit later on, and a low of 31. For tomorrow, Monday, cloudy skies, a chance of light rain by late morning. However, I do think we may see it a little bit earlier because of the rain showers that we're experiencing at this very moment. And we will have a high of 43. For Monday night, the forecast calling for light rain mixing with snow, then changing to wet snow with some accumulations likely, and a low of 35. And on Tuesday, wet snow continuing, and some additional accumulations, and we'll have a high of 38. 33 degrees, and we have some drizzle in the area. Sweet as the punch, the association, and along comes Mary. This is Dan Hill, his latest. I Fall All Over Again on WRDB.
Can't believe we met.
Going back to 1960 with the late, great Roy Orbison and Crying. 8 minutes past 11 o'clock at WRDB, and America's most listened to radio personality can be found right here on WRDB, and that's Paul Harvey. You can listen to Paul mornings at 7:30 during the noon hour, and afternoons at about 5:20 on Sauk County's information station, WRDB.
Hi, my name is Joe Spike, and I am the...
Lloyd Price and Personality. This is Barry Manilow from 1984, and Read 'em and Weep. From the CD album Right Here, Eddie Money, and I'll Get By at 20 minutes past 11, and turning to sports. Sunday sports were made of magic, Martina, and mayhem. The Los Angeles Lakers retired Magic Johnson's uniform number. Martina Navratilova won a record-setting 158th tournament title, and Davey Ellison won a Daytona 500 NASCAR race that included a 14-car wreck. And that wreck at Daytona knocked out many of the favorites about halfway through the race, and that opened the way for Ellison to win his first Daytona 500 title, and his father Bobby won the race three times. Meanwhile, Martina has now won more professional singles tennis tournament titles than any other player. Number 158 came today when Navratilova battled past Jana Novotná 7-6, 4-6, and 7-5 at the Virginia Slims of Chicago. And a Los Angeles Laker uniform bearing the number 32 now hangs inside the forum. The NBA team retired Magic Johnson's number in a 45-minute ceremony at halftime of today's game between L.A. and the Boston Celtics. There were several standing ovations and many words that left Johnson wiping tears off his face. Johnson now joins Jerry West, Elgin Baylor, Wilt Chamberlain, and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar as Lakers with their uniform numbers retired. And Boston won today's NBA game in L.A. The Celtics saw a 22-point first-half lead trimmed to one before pulling away again for a 114-107 win over the Lakers. Detroit coach Chuck Daly called Dennis Rodman's performance in Philadelphia just another day at the office. Rodman had 26 rebounds. Orlando Woolridge scored 34 points, and the Pistons beat the 76ers 90-83. Milwaukee lost its 10th straight road game, and the Orlando Magic beat the Bucks 118-104. 28 points and 13 rebounds from Larry Johnson led the Charlotte Hornets past the Miami Heat 126-109. Number one Duke was the only ranked college basketball team playing today. The Blue Devils got 20 points from Grant. Do keep that in mind tonight. If you're traveling, the roads may tend to get slick as we will drop below the freezing mark. Not much, however. We will have mostly cloudy skies, areas of fog developing, and a low of 31. For tomorrow, Monday, cloudy skies, a chance of light rain by late morning, and a high topping off at 43. On Monday night, light rain mixing with snow, then changing to wet snow with accumulations likely, and a low of 35. And on Tuesday, yes, winter again rears its ugly head in the form of wet snow. That'll continue, additional accumulations likely, and high topping off at 38. We have 33 degrees currently, and light drizzle in Reedsburg.
Now, more of Sauk County's best weekend.